And now we're going to look at the life of Daniel. Daniel, after reading through the life of Daniel, is probably one of those boys who took the greatest stand for God that anyone else has ever lived. Let's recap, look at Daniel at the very beginning. Now, Daniel lived with his friends in Jerusalem, and at the time of in Babylon was King Nebuchadnezzar, and he marched his army over 500 miles, and they captured Jerusalem. They defeated the Israelite army, and they captured some of the people. And he wanted young men who he would train up to know Babylonian law. And four of these people were Daniel and his three friends. And we can read so much in the book of Daniel about these men. He wanted people, he said, children in whom there was no blemish, but well-favored, skillful in all wisdom, and cunning in knowledge, and understanding science, and had such an ability in them to stand in the king's palace, and whom they might teach the learning and the tongue of the Chaldeans. So he wanted people who would be brilliant in learning. And whenever he found Daniel and his three friends, he was going to train them up. And one of the first things they had to do, he said, I want them to sit. Now, Daniel and his friends, when they were brought into this Babylonia, they thought they were going to be put in a dungeon or a prison, but they weren't. They were brought into the king's presence, the king's palace, and they were told to eat the king's meat. Not only Daniel and his three friends, lots of other young men. But most of them, right away, they began to just eat what was put before them and drink the king's wine. But Daniel, he asked the question, has this meat been offered to idols? And it was. So he refused to take it, as his three friends. And also the meat, God told them not to eat specific meats, forbid them to do that. So Daniel and his three friends refused the king's meat, and they refused the wine that the king offered. And this made the man who was in charge over them, it made him cross. Even though they loved and respected Daniel and his friends for being brilliant young men, he said, you need to eat this or the king's going to have my life. And the king, Daniel prayed about it. And he said, no, our God has forbid us to do this. And all his friends didn't care. They just kept eating everything that's put in front of them. But Daniel, by conviction and by his heart and by his conscience, could not eat the king's meat. And he said to him, allow me, give me 10 days, my three friends and me, 10 days. And he refused him. So he went to his superior and he said to him, he asked him, please to the king, give us 10 days just to eat vegetables, not to eat meat and to drink only water, vegetables and water for 10 days. And I promise you, we will look fatter and fresher and our skin will have a better countenance after 10 days than those of the other people eating your meat. And the king says, okay, 10 days. And after 10 days, do you know what the Bible says after 10 days? First of all, Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with a portion of the king's meat, nor with the wine which he drank. Therefore, he requested of the prince of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself. As for the four children, God gave them knowledge and skill in all learning and wisdom, and Daniel had understanding in all visions and dreams. Daniel was a brilliant young man, and after 10 days, do you know what happened? All the wise men stood before the king's wise men, and after 10 days, Daniel and his three friends looked better, and the Bible says they even were 10 times wiser than the king's original wise men, because God had given them a brilliance in learning and understanding. And Daniel, the power could have went to his head, the brains could have went to his head, but it never. And Daniel, before anything else, always put the Lord first. And Daniel, the people said, Daniel, eat the king's meat, do what the king says. Now Daniel respected the king, but he also respected God more than the king. And he asked the king, he was polite, and he says, I will prove to you that I do not need to eat your meat to affect my brain or to affect my performance. And Daniel was being trained up in the ways of the Babylonian law, and he learnt it, and he became a brilliant scholar. But never once did Daniel forget, and he told the king, please don't make me eat your meat. Please don't make me drink your wine. Now Daniel could have easily went the ways of his friends. All of us are challenged if our friends perhaps smoke, drink, maybe take drugs, maybe say bad words, maybe watch bad films, and say, there's nobody else not going to do it, so I'll do it. Daniel could have went with all his friends, but he didn't. He stood alone often, even with his three friends, and said, we will not do that because God does not permit us to do that. And Daniel was a boy of prayer. His three friends and Daniel loved the Lord, and they were renamed as Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, were Daniel's three friends. And we can read all about them in the book of Daniel. And Daniel himself, in verse 6, tells us his new name, what he was going to be called, Belshazzar. These are hard, difficult names, but deep within it, read the book of Daniel, and you can learn so much about the life of Daniel, the great man of God.